What's going on, guys? It's Logan here at the Health Park. Sorry we can't be together as far as our road classes go and personal training. We're gonna do an improvised workout today. See if we can get through some stuff. Have a little bit of fun. I hope to see you guys back very soon. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and get rolling. What we're gonna begin with, 3 sets of 15 reverse lunges, okay? Stationary stance right here. Take a step back. Knee in line with the toe. Nice and smooth. We can make that tougher by adding a little bit of a pause right here. Okay. Also, same leg. Get you a little bit continuous set right here. Great. Keep going. 13. Then we'll switch. Now we'll go right leg planted right here. Take a step back. Smooth. Try to push through that lead leg as much as you can, okay? Go at your pace. 6, 7. Keep going, yep, front leg. The more upright we stay, the more quad it's gonna be. The more we lean with that hamstring, that stretch, we're gonna initiate this a little bit more. Okay, we got our set of 15 right here. Now we're gonna work into a reverse Nordic curl. Good quad stretch, okay? Preferably a mat so it's easy on your knees. Try to emphasize that glute squeeze as much as you can. When you go back, we don't wanna arch your back or compensate with this. Glute squeeze, good quad stretch. Come back up. Stretch, come back. Everything stays in alignment as we go down. See if we can get 8 to 12. Feel the quads. Go until you feel that good stretch. Pause and come up. 8. Only go as your range of motion will allow, okay? Glute squeeze, stretch, okay? Come back up again, okay? There's our set. Reverse Nordic curls are 2. Next after that, okay? We're gonna do a glute bridge drop set. Little bit of a mechanical advantage right here. We're gonna start with the single leg bridge. Knee right here tucked. Front heel up like this. Toes, excuse me. Glute squeeze, everything stays in alignment. So we're gonna go single leg for 10. 7, 8. Everything stays smooth. 10, okay. Once that glute is fatigued, now we switch. 1, 2. Remember, squeeze the glute, hip extension, not lumbar extension. Now, once they're fatigued as individuals, we're gonna bring them together as a unit. Let's see if we can hit at least another 10. Good squeeze. So we go from that unilateral lever to bilateral. Get a good pump. Now, once we're fatigued, we're gonna move on. Okay, we fit our glute max. Next up, glute medius. So we're gonna lay on our side right here. Little bit of a side plank clamshell. Feet tucked, abs engaged. This bottom leg, press it into the ground. Stay right here, squeeze. This way works just fine. Otherwise we can go a little bit more dynamic. Flex at the hip, extend. That's it, 12 to 15 if we can. Push with that bottom leg. Everything stays braced. Bend, extend. Smooth, okay. We'll cycle back around. All right, other side. Everything stays in alignment right here, okay? Don't jeopardize your shoulder. Core engaged. 2. Neck relatively in alignment. Feel it where you're supposed to, okay? A little bit of a pump style workout to begin. And breathe, okay. Hit a big portion of our glutes. Now we're gonna go standing calf raises. Find any sort of beam like this. Good stretch. Really think about driving your ankle forward at the top. We're gonna shoot for 20 to 30. Two. These are deceiving. Good stretch. Explode. Good reflex. Explode. Six. You can hold on to something for a little bit of balance. Eight. Nine. Really try to push through that burn, okay? Let's get some growth. Stretch. Squeeze. Higher rep range for these muscle fibers. 17, 18, 19, 20, let's get 30. 22, stretch, drive through the ball of your foot, hold it down, up, 25, 6, 7, 28, yep, 29, breathe, okay. Now we cycle back around. We're gonna hit one more thing before we do. Kinda open up your groin a little bit. A lot of the times people don't mobilize this area of their body near enough. We're gonna go with the kneeling slide. Open up your adductors right here. Come out, good stretch. Nice and subtle. This is not for really big time gains, hypertrophy stuff, just mobilization, keeps us loose. Six. Seven. Just go until you feel the stretch. Come back up, okay? So from the other side, that quadruped position right here. Slide out, stretch. Nice and controlled. Four, five, yep. Six, seven, breathe. Okay, now we're gonna cycle back around. Feel free to go at your pace. Let's hit those reverse lunges again. And if you all want a variation of that, get a little bit more dynamic with your movement. We'll open up that groin a little bit. Lead, or the back leg goes on the towel. Come down, pause, scoop up. Good stretch. What we're focused on right here, not necessarily putting our legs so far back that we puts our femur in a bind, just dropping that back knee to the ground. Nice and controlled. Subtle stretch, explode. See if we can get 15. 12 to 15. 8. Keep your pace up. Let's get some metabolic stress going. Time under tension. That's a game changer, especially with body weight stuff. Feel the right stuff being worked. Knee in line with the toe. Nice and controlled. Keep it moving. Seven, eight. We can make anything challenging with intensity. Ten. 13, great. 14, yep. Breathe, okay. Let's cycle back around, keeping it going. Nordic curls again, glute squeeze, core engaged, crossed arms, stretch, squeeze, stretch. Everything stays as even as you can. Good eccentric movement for your quads right here, putting on the brakes. Recoil, good. Squeeze, glute involvement right here. 8 to 12 if we can. Right in here. Hold it, explode. Come back up. Okay, once we've hit that, now we're gonna cycle back around. glute bridge drop set. See if we can get those hammies and glutes going. Knee bent to the chest. Squeeze. Two. See if we can get 10 aside. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. All right. Switch. Knee to the chest. Glutes. Seven. Drive those elbows in. Upper back squeezed. Breathe. Once they're both fatigued, let's crank them out. At least 10. Remember, hip extension, not arching the lumbar. Breathe. Okay. Limit your rest. Feet stacked. I like to go with an X pattern right here. Elbow driven in, core engaged. Bend, extend. Bottom leg stays planted. Three, four, yep. Good. Six, seven, eight, push. Feel it in the right spots. 10, 11, yep. 12, see if we can get 15, 13, four, breathe. Go at your pace. Elbow and shoulder stacked. Tension in your fist. Everything's in alignment. Core engaged. We're trying not to sag right here. Everything stays tight. Neck in alignment. We're not jolting out. Arching. Flexing laterally. Everything's neutral. 15, great, okay. Come back over here. Gonna hit our calf raises. Flex, stretch, explode. Fair warning, with this gastroc and soleus being put on a really big eccentric stretch, you may feel this the next day. Very tough on that area of the body, that stretch. Drive through the ball of your foot. 8, 9. Keep pushing. The reps you don't want to do are the ones that mean the most. Keep digging. Right there with you. 6, 8, 9. Breathe. Okay, let's hit this adductor rock one more time. Open up that groin a little bit. Okay, everything stays solid, even right here. Neutral neck. We're not poking forward. A little bit of retraction. Double chin almost. Slide out. Controlled stretch. Come back in. Controlled. Come back in. Three. Let's get eight aside. Try to feel it in a good spot, okay? Five, breathe. Six. More range of motion is not necessarily a good thing if we can't control it. Flexibility is great. We have to have mobility in the right lifts, okay? Compromise under load, not just static stretching and flexing. Yep. There's eight. All right. So let's go ahead and move on. Two rounds, three if you'd like to. Now we're going to move on to an upper body circuit. A little bit of a drop set right here. Okay. So three rounds of that if time allows. So now what we're going to move to right over here, we're going to start with a feet elevated push up. A little bit of a mechanical disadvantage. With your feet being elevated, you've got more torque on your shoulders, more demand on your upper body. So we're gonna try to hit that while we're fresh, okay? Let's see if we can get a clean 10. Everything stays in alignment, glutes engaged, controlled, push through the floor to begin. Six, seven, 8. Controlled, good eccentric stretch. 9, 10. Okay, once we're a little fatigued, lessen the load a bit, little bit. We're going to flat. Keep it going. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We gotta dig a little bit. 9, 10, breathe. All right, so now it's pretty tough for you to hit stuff at home without any weights, especially for your upper back. So if you have anything like a Coke can, TV remote, something very small in weight, I'll be right back. I'm gonna get us a few weights real quick. Anything replicable to this will be just fine, okay? Prone shoulder rotation. Stomach on the ground, hands out wide, turn down, squeeze those rear delts. Anterior and mid, 2. Let's get 10 if we can. Very deceiving. 3, 4, yep. 5, next stays retracted. 6, 7, push a little bit. 8, 9, one more, 10. All right, immediately after, the upper back combo right here. We're gonna stand up. Don't even necessarily have to have weights for this one. Core engaged, rock back and shift at your hamstrings, not rounding the low back. Put the weight into your hamstrings, thumbs up, body weight, rear delt flies. That same mechanics with the drop set. Making those arms feel really heavy. 9, 10, 11. Let's see if we can get 20. 13, 14, 15. As you get fatigued, try not to reach forward with your neck. Everything stays tight. 6, 7, 18, 19. Breathe, okay, 20. So what we're gonna hit right here, I'm gonna show you guys something on the wall called a scapular wall slide. So once we've hit all that, posterior delts are kind of lit up. We're gonna try to keep our hands this kind of prisoner stance right here. Lumbar against the wall, core engaged, chin tucked, slide up the wall. Great chest opener. Counteracts that daily posture. We're sitting at the desk all day, on the phone, kind of hunched over. Tight pectoral muscles, parts of your bicep, anterior delt. Let's get at least 10, 9, 10, 15 if you want to push. Try not to arch the low back, it's very tough. 13, keep them glued. 15, breathe. Just body weight makes a big difference, okay? We're gonna try to cycle through that one more time. That's all right, be careful, be careful. There you go. All right, we're gonna start with those feet elevated push-ups. Like I said, if time allows, we're gonna shoot for 3 rounds. Okay, start with that drop set. Shoulders are fresh, the external rotators are primed. Let's get into it. Core engaged. Think about pushing yourself away from the ground. Once you come up top, get that serratus going, that boxer muscle. Back of your shoulder blade. Push up plus. 10, okay. Immediately after, vary your stance according to your anatomy, whatever feels good. Tucked elbows a little bit so we're not so much chicken winged. Core engaged. Breathe. Okay, breather for a second. Go at your speed. We're gonna hit our prone rotations again. Get that upper back going. Try to keep your core engaged a little bit right here as well. When you come up, we don't wanna be so hyperextended in your lumbar, okay? A little bit of pressure. Don't sacrifice shoulder and scapula movement for lumbar movement, okay? Here we go. Thumbs up, come down. 2, 3. Body weight is fine with this. Really get that squeeze. Low trap, rhomboid, a little bit of lat. Okay, immediately after, let's get that upper back feeling heavy. Initiate, core engaged, hamstrings back, tall of the T-spine. Get 20, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 6, 7, 9. Breathe. Okay, we're gonna hit these wall slides one more time. Open up that chest. Get in the zone. Let's try to finish strong right here. You wanna be efficient with your fatigue levels, okay? Not so much that form is compromised, but you keep your heart rate up. Try to keep your rib cage down, not so much inhaling through your chest, intercostal muscles. Push yourself. Think about what you want. 15, great. Okay, get your breather real quick. I'm gonna get a slight drink if I can. Then we're gonna move into some dynamic core work. Wait 1 second. All right. So for this next circuit, it's gonna be core, dynamic movements, a little bit of cardio as well. So if you don't mind, we'll kind of come over here again and use this wall. Elevated surfaces are a game changer with loads, mechanical leverages, fulcrum points. Very easy way to make body weight tougher, okay? So what we're gonna start out right here with some mountain climber. Not one right way to do it. Sometimes though, that speedy move, a lot of people tend to get really out of rhythm. They don't feel it in the right spots. So we're gonna try to go elevated and very controlled, okay? Feet on the wall. See if we get our footing right. Hold. Nice and controlled. If you want to make it more dynamic, explode. Hip flexor. 10 aside. Breathe. Okay. You can do those same patterns on the ground as well once that gets too heavy. Okay. Bird dogs next. Same thing right here. Not so erratic that when we come, we're cranking through the lumbar. Fishtailing a little bit. It's all about staying centered, okay? Your body's a unit. Come out nice and controlled. If you want to make that tougher, we can go lift that back foot up a little bit. More aggressive way, we'll stay planted right here. As you can see, I'm already a little fatigued. Breathe. Let's get 10 aside, okay? If that's still too aggressive, we can really regress that as well. One hand out in front, same side would be easiest. Manipulate that, offset the leverages. Okay, since your leg's a bigger lever, next step, glute squeeze, same side. Make it a little tougher, okay? Then we start to incorporate the opposite hand. Opposite leg movement. Let's get 10 aside. Okay, either kind of prone or in that all four stance. Beware if you do that, you're gonna feel a really big quad pump. Breathe. Okay, next up right here, we're gonna try a bear crawl maneuver. So we're actually gonna go up and down on the floor, if that's okay. All right, same thing right here. Be mindful if you want to put something on your low back to keep you really in check. Everything stays level. Not one right way to do them. Sometimes people get really out of whack. It's all about a speed thing. They start to disperse it on their shoulders, elbow joints, kneecaps. Stay level, stay rigid. Heck of a shoulder burn. Good rotator cuff workout. Core engaged, quad burn, okay? Pick a distance. Put something on your low back if you'd like to. Really keep yourself in check. Multitude of ways you can do this, all right? For instance, lateral motion, if you wanted to change it up. All kinds of different ways. It's all about staying level, guys. It's a game changer. Come down. Okay, we breathe again. Slider reaches. All right. Be mindful with this. Keep a little bit of a bend in your elbow so we're not coming down on a fully loaded joint. Go at your speed. We'll start with the regression first. Knees, I prefer to have my feet crossed, core engaged, glute squeeze so we don't hyperextend that lumbar. Come out, reach as far as you can without sagging or rotating. Come back in. Reach. Three. We'll do regression one way, progression the next. Four. Five. 8 to 10 aside would be great. Stay level. Let's get 8. And then we'll try it from this stance, okay? We come up. More of a push-up variation. Okay, a good 8 aside. After that, side planks, okay? Let's stay really level right here. Elbow stacked. You'll see a lot of people on that elbow joint and shoulder joint, they're gonna be hanging out in that capsule like this. We need to stay centered and planted, okay? Everything stays stacked. Hold it. Multitude of ways we can change this. Hold the weight above our head, okay? Stack with our foot like this. A little bit more groin. Hold it for a good pause. Breathe. You can also elevate your feet as well. Box, Bosu ball, anything with stability, okay? Like we talked about, elevation's a game changer. Okay, everybody ready? Stacked. Bridge, glute squeeze. We're not hanging out. Neck retracted, core engaged. Fist squeezed. Go for a good burn. Quality over quantity. I'd much rather have 15 clean seconds than 30 where we're hanging out on the wrong joint, okay? Feel it where you're supposed to. We will get there. Breathe, okay. We're gonna try to run through that one more time before we call it a day. 3 rounds is optional. Okay, let's try the mountain climbers from the ground. Little progression we didn't show. Everything stays solid. Hold. Hold. Try to feel that lower rectus. Those abs fire up a little bit, okay? Your hip flexors a little bit. Balance, even, even. A ball, weight plate, bottle of water. It's gonna make a big difference on your low back, okay? Bird dogs again, elevated to begin. If you would like to try that, we'll stay planted. Breathe. Okay. Breather for a second. Come back the other way. Stay tucked. Extend. Try to stay level. Balance that water. 6, 7, 8, 9. Breathe. Okay. We're almost there, guys. Let's keep pushing. All right. Instead of the bear crawl, another variation I can show you guys. It's a plank with abduction or a toe tap. You can also do this elevated, but we're gonna try to go right here on the forearms. Okay, stay centered. Toe tap, come back. Let's get 8 aside. 8 to 10 if we can.
Breathe.
Okay, almost there. All right, let's revisit that slider reach. And please, if you guys ever see me around, see me out, see me here, ask me a question. Love to work with you on your form, keeping everything regimented and getting to a new level if we can, okay? So we'll reach. Two. Regression right here, still challenging. Do not sell yourself short. Six. Seven. Feel that lat stretch too. That armpit muscle. Breathe. Okay, let's finish strong right here. Regression, planted right here. Stay tight. A little bit of a glute squeeze if you need to. Breathe. Okay, one more time. We're gonna hit that side crunch. Try to finish on a strong note, and then we'll call it a day. Push yourself a little bit. Think about what you want. Work for it. All right. Everything stays tight. Core engaged, glute squeezed, fist squeezed. Control your breathing. 10, 11, 14, 15, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. All right, guys, one more time, and we'll call it a day. We can make it work. All right, let's get up, finish strong, good bridge, everything stays tight. Weight in your hand if you want it. Six, eight. Push that right elbow into the ground. Give your shoulders some clearance. Don't get relaxed. Puts a lot of stress on that humerus. Six, seven, eight, nine. Breathe. All right, so like I said, optional three rounds. You want to move fast, maybe a lunch hour break. Come to one of my boot camps. We'd love to have you. My name is Logan Mattingly. Thank you all for watching very much. Hope to see you guys very soon. Take care.